VPN gives online protection and so does TOR, but not many consider VPN with TOR or even TOR over VPN. What's the difference? I'm going to answer that question and explain precisely whether you should combine TOR with VPN or is that not a good idea. But first, I need to get the TOR browser explained first. So, what is TOR? The onion router is a telling name, since TOR deals with lots of layers much like a certain ogre. TOR essentially applies three layers of protection. First, your data goes to the entry node, the only one that would know who is accessing the connection. After that, the connection is routed through an intermediary node and into an exit node, the only node that knows what data is outputted, but not where it comes from. And you might be asking, what's the difference between TOR browser versus VPN? After all, VPNs also encrypt and transfer your connection through a remote server similar to TOR's nodes. People also often use the TOR VPN name when referring to TOR, which is not really accurate. The difference of TOR versus VPN is also layered. First of all, TOR nodes are all users of the TOR service, unlike VPN servers, which are data centers belonging to the company. Second difference of VPN versus TOR is servers. While you can choose a VPN server to connect to, TOR nodes are chosen by random, meaning there could be huge delays on your connection and you can't choose your exit node. And finally, VPNs apply encryption to your information and break it into packages, which adds a layer of security. TOR just isn't able to provide that. Does that mean VPN versus TOR battle is lost for the latter? Not at all. Both actually have downsides. VPNs may keep data logs on their servers, and TOR nodes could be compromised, revealing your data. Also, ISPs are really suspicious of TOR users. But they don't have to be, if they don't know you are using the TOR browser. Okay, by now you already got it. You can use TOR and VPN combination. Your ISP won't know a thing, there will be an extra security layer due to encryption, and the triple node system is very secure by itself. The benefits of using VPN and TOR together are pretty apparent. Obviously, even that isn't perfect. TOR already slows the internet down, so when using TOR with a VPN, I get even slower speeds most of the time. And you can't choose the exit node while setting TOR over VPN, limiting your options. However, you can use VPN over TOR instead. This way, your exit node will depend on the VPN configuration, but I don't recommend doing that. The whole purpose of the TOR over VPN maneuver is to hide from your ISP, increase security, and prevent the entry node from knowing your identity. VPN with TOR invalidates those things completely. So check this out. This table perfectly summarizes the difference between these two ways of using VPN with TOR. There are benefits and downsides to both, but generally speaking, using TOR over VPN is a way with most positives over detriments. So then, let me show you how to use TOR browser with a VPN. First, grab a VPN. I will use Surfshark here, since I already have a subscription, but you can get any other one as long as it has good security and privacy standards. If you are struggling with a choice, I will leave my recommendations in the description. After you have a VPN, use it to connect to the desired location, and it can be the fastest server for simplicity. Most VPNs have the quick connect button on the main screen, that's what I'm referring to. Now, download and install the TOR browser. It's the primary way to connect to the TOR network, and it's not hard to use. Just follow through the installation and run TOR like you would any other browser. See? Works like clockwork. Congratulations, you are awesome! And well, ISP does not know that you are using TOR and your browsing experience is safe, but mostly you are awesome. So to summarize, TOR is a software designed to make your online experience untraceable, much like a VPN. However, since both have downsides, you can potentially combine them to end with a net positive, minus the connection speed, of course. I hope this video helped to get the TOR browser explained for you guys, and if you want more topics like that, leave a comment and let me know. I will see you again soon with another video. Take care.